हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेस टॉपिक इज क्वेश्चन टैग और टैग क्वेश्चन। टैग क्वेश्चन आर क्वेश्चन दैट आर फॉर्म बाय एडिंग एन इंटरोगेटिव टैग एट द एंड ऑफ द सेंटेंसेस। टैग क्वेश्चन कंटेन अ हेल्पिंग वर्ब एंड अ सब्जेक्ट प्रोनाउन। इट मीन्स क्वेश्चन टैग, वी एड क्वेश्चन टैग एट द एंड ऑफ द सेंटेंस एंड a question tag contains helping verb and the subject pronoun. She is beautiful. When we add the question tag in this sentence, then we will place the comma, like here she is beautiful comma, then helping verb. What is the helping verb of this sentence? Is. Then firstly we will write is, and I have written here not, isn't. Why I have written? When I've explained this rule, then you come to know. Isn't, and what the subject? She. Then I've written here, she, and it's a question tag, that's why we will put the question mark at the end. Then isn't she. Okay. These are some rules which we should follow. Let's see. If the sentence is positive, the question tag is negative. It means students, when our sentence is positive, then we will add the negative question tags. Negative means we will add negative words. She is preparing well. She is preparing well. As we can say, this is a positive sentence because in this sentence there is not any negative word. It means we will add the negative question tag. Then what we will do, firstly we will put the comma. What the helping verb? Is the helping verb. Then we will write firstly is. As I have told, it's the positive sentence. Then we will add the negative question tag. Then we will write not, isn't. What the subject? She is the subject. Then she. And question mark. They were waiting for us. What the helping verb? Were. Then we will put the comma and write were and add the not because the positive sentence, then we will add the negative question tag. Weren't. What the subject? They is the subject. Then write they and question mark. Next, see help Tom. See help Tom. Student, as we can see that there is not any helping verb in this sentence. Then we will, according to the tense, we will add the helping verb. Which tense it is? As we can see, help is the second form of the verb. And it means it's the simple past tense. We use the second form of the verb in the simple past tense. And what is the helping verb of simple past tense? It's did. Then we will write did. Then did, it's the positive sentence. Then we will write not, didn't. Subject is she. Then we will write here she and question mark. Next, the people of this area are modern. What's the helping verb? Are is the helping verb. Okay, then we will write firstly aren't. As you can see, students, I have written here they. Why? Because according to the subject, we will write the pronoun. Students, when we add the question tag, then we will always write the pronoun in the quotient tag. We will not write the noun, and people is a noun. We do not write noun in the quotient tag. Then we will change this noun into the pronoun and then write pronoun. And according to the people, what is the pronoun? We will write they. People is plural, that's why we will add the plural quotient tag. And it's a they. Then they and question mark. Next, Priya likes to draw pictures. Priya likes to draw pictures. As you can see in this sentence, there is also not given any helping verb. Then we will find out which tense it is. Then we will firstly see the verb. What is verb? Likes. And it's the first form of the verb. It's the first form. It means it's the simple present tense. In simple present tense, we write the first form of the verb. And what is the helping verb of simple present tense? Do and does. Then according to the subject, we will write. Priya is singular, then we will write the singular helping verb. Does is used with singular and do is used with plural. Then we will write does. And Priya is is a girl, and for Priya, which pronoun we will use? She. For Priya, we will use she. Then doesn't, it's a positive sentence, then we will write not, doesn't. According to Priya, we will write C and question. Okay. Remember, students, in question tag, we do not change the tense. What is the tense? I have written the same. I have not changed the tense. It means we will not change the tense and we will write the pronoun according to the subject. Next. If the sentence is negative, the question tag is positive. If sentence is negative, then we will add the positive question tags. Okay. She isn't a student. It means it's a negative sentence because there's given not negative word. Then we will add the positive question tag. It means we do not write any negative word in the question tag. Then the same rule we will follow. Put the comma, write the helping verb. Is the helping verb. Then write the subject. You can see I have not written here not because it's a negative sentence and we will add the positive question tag. Next, Maya doesn't speak French fluently. What the helping verb? Does. We write does. And Maya is a girl, and for girl, for female, we use she pronoun. Then I have written here she and question mark. They don't live in Paris. Firstly, we write helping verb do. It's already given there do, and subject and question mark. What is the subject? They and question mark. He wasn't happy. Then we will put the comma, write the helping verb was. What is the subject? He. Then we will write he and question mark. As we can see, this sentence is negative, that's why we have used the positive question tag. It means, students, when our sentence is positive, then we will add the negative question tags. When our sentence is negative, then we will use the positive question tag. Next, if a sentence contains negative words like never, seldom, hardly, ever, we generally use positive question tag because these are the negative words, that's why we will use the positive question tags. She never comes late. Then we will see which tense it is. We will see the verb. Verb is in the first form. It means it's the simple present tense. And in simple present tense, we use the do or does. That's why I've written here does. Sorry, according to the subject, she is the subject. For that, I have written here does. It hardly ever rains in a desert. Same, there's not given any helping verb, then we will see the tense. What's the verb? Rains, and it is in the first form. It means it's a simple present tense. And I have told helping verb of simple present tense is do or does. Then according to the subject, we will write do or does. Then it is singular, that's why we will write does. Then does. It and question mark. As you can see, there is written never and hardly. That's why I have used the positive question tags. Student, there are some words like some, every, any, no. We can add one and body in these words and make like someone, everyone, anyone, no one, somebody, everybody, anybody and nobody. With these words, we will always write the singular helping verb. But students, when we add the question tag, then we will write the plural helping verb and write they as a subject. It's a singular subject, but we write they. If the main subject is everybody, everyone, etc., we use the subject they in the question tag, as I've told you. Let's see how. Someone has forgotten this bag. I've written here someone. Okay, according to someone, has is used here and it's a singular helping verb. But as I've told you, when we will find this type of words, then we will write the they, and according to they, we will write the plural helping verb. When we write they, then we write plural helping verb. Then we will change has into have, and it's the positive sentence. As we can see, then we will write not, haven't, they. No one objected, comma. We can see there's not any helping verb, and objected it in the second form. It means it's the simple past tense. And then we will write did. Helping verb of simple past tense is did. Okay. And no one is given there. That's why we write they. But students, as you can, I have not written here not. Why? Because there is already given no. It means it's the, there is no need to write not again. Student, something, everything, anything and nothing. With these words, we also write the singular helping verb. But when we change this, when we add quotient tag in this sentence, then we will write the same helping verb, singular helping verb. And but we will, according to for these subject, we will write it. Why? Because something, everything, they represent the object. They represent the object. That's why we will write it in the quotient tag. Like, everything is ready now, isn't it? Everything is ready now, isn't it? As you can say, what is given there is a helping verb is given here, and is the positive sentence. Then we will add negative quotient tag, isn't, and everything is given there. For everything, we will write it. Okay, and then put the question mark. I hope, student, you all have understood.